Hey there, viewers. Eric O here, South Main Auto. Welcome back to our channel. If you're brand new here, welcome to our channel. We've got a new vehicle to work on today. We've got this 05 Honda Odyssey that got dropped off. The guy said his passenger door is messed up. He said it messed up on him when they were out and about or whatever happened there. So he cut the cables on it. Evidently it didn't help, but he's cut the cables. So, needless to say, we have to replace the cable and motor assembly now. And I also got what I assumed is probably the initial problem. It's the door roller. These go bad, and they go bad often. So, I've got that, so we've got to replace that. However, I did have to buy the new motor assembly. So we'll take a look at that and see what this thing looks like. So we got this big old honky-tonk here. There's his cables that he cut. So evidently we have to install this. Like I say, I assume this was probably the initial problem, but that's just guessing. I don't know. He got excited. He cut the cable. And I think that may have been an expensive learning lesson, because I don't believe these are very cheap. What's interesting is this package has already been opened. It wouldn't be a self-made auto video unless we got parts that have already been touched. So hopefully it's good. At least it's not a doorman one. Maybe it's one somebody plugged in and fried, and we're gonna find out. I shouldn't even say that. Well, it opens. That's good. Feels like it's dragging a little bit grady, but there is, you know, frays of cable back there on that roller hinge. So at any rate, let's get started. Try to record this the best I can. Sometimes it's pretty tricky on interiors, so basically I just took the back seat and flipped it down and shoved the middle row there forward a little bit, because we've got to take off this rear inner quarter panel trim. So we're gonna have to look and see what we're gonna need to do that, because if memory serves me right, the motors sit in this general area here. So we've got to take this apart, which doesn't look like too big a job. Got a canned animal last year. I've got a French fry on this one. Let's save that for later. Package of iodized salt to season it up. So, see what we're gonna need for tools and we'll get started. Well, first of all, I'm gonna jump the gun laying down the seats, because looks like we've gotta take this threshold off here in the rear, which is pretty easy. Doesn't look like we're gonna need any tools for that. So it looks like just a couple of these cargo net retainers there that are both on the inside. You take those off. Probably just pulls up. Nope. Yeah, that's... Of course, I had this little thing here, but that appears that it perhaps has been broken for a while. It's just laying down in there, so we'll check that out when we get it back together. But you can see the panel here just has these little push retainers, so pulled the bottom ledge out first and then picked it straight up off. Yep, no big deal. Dorito, sweet. That was good. All right. So lay that back down. Looks like we've got another one of those cargo net retainers here we're gonna take off. Over here down on our seat belt, we'll get that popped off. Alright, so we got to unhook the seat belt. So we got to get to the bolt to hold the seat belt on. So we got to get this little cover off. And these are usually held on with these little push tabs that lock down into it. If I remember right, get this front one to pop out. Sometimes they're pretty rigid. There we go. I always feel like you're gonna break them, you know. But the plastic on Hondas is pretty resilient, to be honest with you. So that's what they look like. So you do have the little white retainer tab there. You've got that one there, and you know, this other one here. So pop that out. That gives us access to our seatbelt bolt now, which we can take off, which, you know, previously was being covered up by this piece here. So, oh, let's see. We gotta pull this threshold off because it looks like the plastic here on this quarter panel trim goes underneath it. So usually these thresholds just pop up off, straight off. And you can see, you know, we've got a retainer there, we've got a retainer there, there and there, and supposed to be one here. And it's still stuck down inside the body there, so we'll pop that off. But yeah, just some plastic retainers, snaps straight up off, no big deal. Ah, pizza? Anyone? Pizza? So that's what the little retainers look like. Pretty standard issue stuff. And if you know, if you see or miss one, if it sticks in the body, just pull it out and stick it back in. And being that we're right here, we'll just unhook this seat belt. So you gotta pull the little rubber cap up there. I don't know what that is, probably like a, I was gonna say about 14, so 14 mil. We'll zip that out. And we'll go inside and get the one that's in there. So we got the one down here in the floor. And same thing, should be a 14. Had a little more soda spilled on it, so it came out a little harder. All right, so what I want to do next is I'm going to start here in the back corner towards the gate and start popping this quarter panel trim loose. I think it should be just held on with, you know, push retainers and, you know, locks here, so it should come out pretty easy. I don't believe there's any fasteners anywhere. I didn't see any right off, and it doesn't feel like it's attached by much, so that's what I'm going to do. Pull your rubber weather stripping back a little and be able to get your fingers in there. Then we can have a look with a flashlight. Just be sure. Yep, it's just the white retainers, just like that threshold was. What I'll do is once we get this off, I'll set it out on the floor so you can see the location of each retainer. Now there is a slot here you're gonna have to open up. This one is already kind of open. You have to feed your seat belt through it, which is pretty easy. So take off this trim panel first. We get a better look at that. Well, it appears that way, that this trim panel here on the, I guess it would be the C pillar, overlaps the gray quarter panel plastic, unlike it did in the rear. So it appears that that has to come off. So we'll see what we need to do to take that off. So we need to expose the bolt that holds this on. There's those two locks. Sometimes this stuff can be pretty tricky sometimes, getting the right method. I see it's latched on at the top. But you always want to use a, you know, plastic prying device, because somehow deep down inside you feel better. If I'm using plastic, I can't break plastic. There's one side. At any rate, so there's a couple latches on the very top of it. So you basically pull the top out, kind of tip it forward here, and then there's a couple retainer tabs right here on either side that you have to reach down in here and kind of pry these little wings back, pull it straight out. It's kind of hard to illustrate that for you, but I can describe it the best I can. Maybe show you what it looks like. Anyhow, like I say, their plastic's pretty resilient. I'll give them that. We'll buzz that seatbelt out. And then this quarter panel trim. Gooey. There. Pull that back. Realistically, we don't need to take it any further than just leaving it loose, because that gives us access to our seat belt that is behind there. There's another slot that it's got to slide through, so I think that gives us what we need. Instead of going up in there any further, we'll just finish pulling this quarter trim out and just do the job. I haven't done many interior videos. It's tough. It's tight quarters for me and you. Gotta pull this weather stripping off all the way here in the front back edge of this door, I guess. Pull that back. Finish popping our trim off. Like I say, there's no sense in fidgeting with that C-pillar anymore. Pull it back. You'll see the slot that I'm talking about to guide your seatbelt out of. It's not much different than the one that was back there. That's it. Take this thing out. Well, there's the back side of your quarter panel trim, so pretty cut and dry. Just got these little white push retainers all the way across here. You've got one metal clip here, another metal clip there, another one there. And this would be the door edge on this side. So those metal retainers there were where the weather stripping sat into it. Of course, on the back edge of the door, we just have a couple clips. So looks like we're missing one there. Perhaps it may be still stuck in the van. We'll have to check that out. Okay, now we saw that. I do not see. So that one plastic retainer is missing. It'd be one of these four holes. I don't see it. So it's a good chance it wasn't there. Or it's been opened up before, because I don't see where it would have fallen off or anything. And frankly, it comes apart quite easily. Interesting side of the van to tear apart. It's got your whole HVAC unit back here, so that's pretty cool if you've never seen that. That's where all the rear blower motor and, you know, you got your heater lines and your AC lines and stuff running through here. But I think the part we're after is behind door number one. It's got all this black snot on it. You kind of got to, kind of like skinning a deer. Just got to kind of pull it back and start cutting away the adhesive here. There it is. There's our motor hidden back there, and there's our power sliding door control module. There's a lot of wires back here, so if your razor blade is sharp, unlike mine, you might want to be careful. heck is holding me down there? This one little tiny piece. Okay, it's where it loops around. What's that loop around? Loops around something down there, wiring harness or something or other, but that's what your water shield looks like. I think that's the technical term. That's what we're gonna call it. Okay. So it appears to me, this may be a little more difficult. Got two bolts here. There's another bolt right here. It's right behind this wiring harness underneath the low pressure line here. So we're gonna have to loosen some stuff up to get into that lower bolt. This is part of the cable assembly, this thing here. It kind of runs around. So I say we take the whole seatbelt bracket out. Let's pull this speaker out. That'll give us access to the cable that runs this direction. The one that goes this way, well, I'm not real sure. I hope we don't have to pull the whole HVAC unit out of it. Best I can see, it's behind that heater system. I don't know if we can loosen it up and just pull it back or not. Get this speaker out of our way. See what the heck's going on over here. And we'll zip that seatbelt out, like I say. It's like a 14 and a 10. The speaker took an 8, in case you're keeping track. That's out of there. That's also held in with the black goo on a wiring harness. Oops, careful. Okay, just a little styrofoam cup. There's our cable. That's where that goes. Oh man, it's been a long day. Tell you what, before we get too excited about that other cable and this HVAC stuff, we'll get this tail light out of here and get some tools. Another 8mm. 3/8 impact should handle it. Never have anything to get a hold of. See our cable anywhere near this area. Take that trim panel off up here. It's a 10mm, just holds this metal trim right by the sliding door here, right ahead of the tail light. You come up in here by in the front side of the sliding door, you reach way back in here with a Phillips head screwdriver. Another screw there, so we'll take that panel off. Oops, sorry about the wobbly. So once you get that screw out, slide that door ahead a little bit, see if that'll stay. And we've got to We don't want it to slide all the way. Slide that panel forward, and that'll come right off. So you slide it in a forward fashion and take it out. We can see right here, this is where our cable comes through. And unfortunately, it's right behind the HVAC unit. So now we see it, now we gotta deal with it. I don't even know where we left off. There's like a zillion people stopping in. Okay, let's, obviously we can't get it from the outside, so pull this air duct off. Let's see, it's got a little plastic container here. So once you get that one off, it looks like we're gonna have to lift this one up here a little bit too. So we'll get, on that one. So this style retainer, oh, you guys can't see. This style retainer here, you just push the center in, and then you, oops, then the whole thing pops out. The lighting in here is kind of hard because of the backlighting, sorry. Okay, and that allows that to come up. So my hope is, with those two air ducts off, that we can take and loosen up this HVAC unit, get back there enough to at least do what we have to do. There's another one. So look at that. See, I knew Honda wouldn't make it all weird and difficult. I said, may have spoke too soon, but look, let me grab my flashlight. Well, I could see what I need to see, but it sure would be nice if this, if we could pick it up and bring it out a little bit. It's hitting this module right here, so we're gonna pull this module out. One bolt on that. Another one way at the bottom. You guys see? Take those two bolts out. Set those to the side. Use a 10 millimeter. And move that out. Let's see if that allows us to, because we're gonna have a drain here in the bottom. Kind of pick that up and out of the drain. Pick your air duct off. That allows us a pretty substantial amount of room to move. Easily see back there, we're gonna be able to do what we have to do. I'm not gonna bother unhooking AC and cooling stuff. That would be ridiculous because we can get back there now. So behind the HVAC unit, there's this plastic insert. Kind of tip this out a little. I don't know if that'll come out all the way or not. I had just a few fingers that were locking in. I just touched it and it pretty much came undone, so slide that up out of the way. This great big plastic thing has these little lock tabs at the top. I just push it down, it easily pops loose. So now that that is out, hope this video is turning out good. There is what we were after. So we had to do all that to get to that. Being that I'm right here, I grab my 10 millimeter and we're just gonna zip the nuts off that. It looks like there's only three. Oops, dropped that one. So now there's only two. Ah, just kidding, I'll get it. Simply unhook the cable. I don't know if there's enough room. Okay, so it goes through a wire holder. And it has a little retainer tab right here. We're gonna have to kind of, you'll see it as you're wiggling this thing around. probably comes on the new cable assembly, so we'll push this through. All right, we've got that loose. Not worried about kinking this cable because, frankly, it's already junk. There we have it. So the hard one's done. Now we only got three on the front. That's right. I'm sure we'll find it. And because the cables are already cut, this procedure is going to be a little bit different. We've got another wire retainer there. Like I say, as you're doing it, you're going to see, you'll see these. Just got the little fingers. You got to push one at a time down. Do that, pop it out, piece of cake. Just kind of pull that through, and that's it. We've got to unhook the motor and probably take this control unit out of our way and get a screwdriver. Take this control unit out because I think it's going to give us a little more access. And it does, it gives us access to the electrical connectors. So once you pull this loose, what we got back here? Looks like two electrical connectors, brown one and a blue one. Pretty simple. Push the release tab down with your finger. Pull it out. I'd like to do some better video on this one, but boy, frankly, I kind of want to get the job done, and really it's difficult to do inside. Part of me is wishing I didn't start it, but the other part of me wants to finish it. I'm going to loosen up the module there. Yeah, module, the motor. The two top holes appear to be keyway'd. I put a new snap ring on my impact. Makes it tough. But now we've got to get to the lower one, which is not keyway'd, but you can see you can just stick an extension in there. Save that one for last because I just want to leave my extension in there because it'll be a pain to try to fish that through there. So that should work like that. Now we only got two bolts in that. Boy, we are running out of bolts for this thing. I'm just kidding. You know I'll put them back. Or at least I'll tell you I'm gonna. What in the thunder are we hitting on? Oh, ain't that just something? You know what? They keyway that thing. But it makes no sense because I think that's what's holding us up. And it is. That tricks us. We're like, hey, we'll leave them in. We'll slip it right out of there. Not the case. Yeah, I can just see that. That engineer, he's laughing. Got that baby out of there. Let's go get the new one. Bring our trusty magnet. Got the bolt we dropped. Now, hey, look. They even tricked us again because it came with nuts in it or bolts in it already. But we know darn well. Well, you know what? These are in a little bit further, so let's see if it'll fit with it. It's going to be tight. It's going to be close. Of course, now we've got cable, so we got to feed the kind of hold it with one hand and feed the cable right here. And here comes another visitor. Let's see if we can fish this down in there. Ah, look at that. So we just had to have the bolts turned in a little bit further, it appears. Then it kicks down right in there. So cool. Okay, that visitor is leaving. We're starting over. So the bolt I left down here in the bottom. Now my flashlight's dying, it's blinking. We're gonna get that started. ratchet there. Torque that to factory specs, of course. Same thing with the top two. Get those snugged up. Might be something to put this whole thing together and get to plug it in, wouldn't it? Got it re-plugged in. Now we just gotta kinda reverse everything we did. Got all your cables fed up through there. We're gonna have to unwind this one and fish it through the hole. Some tiny cable. Fed through. Get the bolts back on that. It did come with a new wire holder here, so we'll just take and click that in. Same thing with the back cable. It came with that new black holder, so we will also fish this in. Bring that over. Slide your cable through the opening. It's pretty straightforward. If you've made it to this point. Up on those three studs and put your wire retainer back through the hole there by the seat belt, the top right hand corner of the seat belt. That clicks through. All right, piece of cake. So we'll get our four bolts put back in this one. All torqued down and we'll be good to go. Get the other one done, get our seat belts back in and HVAC unit on. I think before we do that, before we get all this crap together, we'll go outside and get it hooked up to the door, change that roller real quick. If that's a real quick job, that is. That way there, if we have a problem, leak it in. We can address it while everything's still opened up, you know, before we get too far ahead of ourselves. Beautiful. Let's see, there's no reason we cannot reinstall our module. Make sure you've plugged in the electrical connector this time. Don't want to forget that. We'll put our couple of Phillips head screws back in that. Pretty easy job, really. It's kind of nice that Honda left this all one modular unit to remove. We'll just be able to have enough latitude of adjustment there to set that to the side. So that's in. We'll get our three nuts back on the back. There is only three studs, so it definitely wasn't missing one. Got those three right here. I sure hope this video is turning out good. I can't tell with the screen, everything looks dark. But previous experience tells me sometimes a little screen on that camera doesn't really portray what it shows up on the big screen, so we're gonna keep going. It's either gonna be good or it's gonna suck. Tighten down. There's no reason we can't just put our HVAC unit, pop it back up on the drain. There's a drain, like I say, down in the floor. I assume that's what it is. And we'll get that popped in there, but we'll get our white piece shoved back in there first. So it just kind of rests back in there. It sits right on the ledge real nice. Just a real light retainer that holds it in. Nothing too fancy pants there. It's our old set that outside. Oh man, my knees. Pick that back up, set it on the drain. You know what, we've got to install this. Popped off, forgot to show you. So this goes up on top. We've got to stick that back up inside that duct. Oops. Get that realigned, and we'll slide the HVAC in. Don't want to forget that. Whoa! That's really holding it. What do we need? We need our bolts. Three of those. One of them started before it pops back out on me. There's three of them total, if you remember right. It's got one there. And they're going to be the three longer ones, so they look very similar to the ones you took out of the this module back here. But these three longer ones are the ones that go in the HVAC box. In, we'll get these all tightened up. Got a couple, another air duct we got to add, a little plastic retainer. So we've got this plastic one that goes up top. Now, I showed you on these are kind of unique. I didn't realize it before I popped it out, well, what style it was. So you push the center of the pin down to get these out. So to put them back in, you actually have to kind of spread them open and push the pin back up. It's kind of hard to explain until you actually use it, but you get the pin pushed back up. Go ahead and we can reinstall it where it belongs. Then you push the pin down and it locks it in. They're a pretty cool fastener, I think. Unless you just go at it like an animal, like I did, just pry it out of there. Put this module back here, reinstall that. It's a key weight on the bottom, it's open like a little camel toe. It slips back over that bolt, so you can put the bolt in first, I guess. Didn't have to remove it all the way. They tricked me again. Yeah, you have to have the bolt in just the right depth. Donsky. Grab that. Oh yeah, I was fighting with this one. This is the one that goes on the wiring harness. I could not get that little sucker out of there. So I set it to the side. Ah, beat you now. So we're gonna take and line this up on the lower portion of the duct. It goes down into the floor. Then outside of that one, obviously, because of the foam. Get that white retainer on there. Gotta put this back on the wiring harness. Because if I don't, I'd lose sleep. So we're gonna take this tape off. We'll redo it real quick. Put it back in the way it was. That way I keep this harness out of the way. I'll be in good shape. I peeled the tape off. I'll show you how I like to do these. These are just the wiring harness retainers. Probably most people just want harness retainer. I just put them back on with zip ties, so I'll simply click them back where they belong. I'll take a zip tie instead of trying to, you know, fidget around with tape. Just take a zip tie, wire tie it to the one wing on it, come right around and do it to the other one. It's a whole lot faster. Just gonna knock them off. Spin around there. Then that wire harness is held on there like it's supposed to be. And we didn't have to use any tape or try to get the tape around there. Okay, I think, let me look at my parts pile. I think we're at a good stopping point. Well, no, we can put that seat belt back in. I don't really anticipate having any issues with this. But then again, the package was opened, so you never know. It could all hit the proverbial fan still. Stick our little foam cut back in there just as it was. I'm just kind of sitting there and take to the harness. What do we got here? Got the top. Make sure it doesn't matter if it's twisted because it's unhooked on both ends. That there. And then the top took the bolt there. That was a 10 millimeter socket. Took the 14, so I'm gonna get these snugged up, and then I think we're at a good stopping point to go ahead and go outside and, you know, change that roller, whatever that takes, get the cables hooked up. Looks like I got some you know, some tensioning devices there we're gonna have to push in, and then we'll power it up and make sure it works, see if there's some kind of rehoming procedure that has to be done first. If there is, we'll handle that and finish putting this thing back together. So it looks like, let me open up this bag. Here's our roller assembly. It's not the entire hinge. It's got a pin that goes through it. It's gonna lock up in the door track. Got our rollers there, got a roller there. It's pretty rusty. And the pin goes from the bottom up. It's got a C-clip on it. It's held on with two bolts. I'm gonna take the whole thing off and beat it apart on the bench and then reinstall it. So we're gonna have to have something to support the back side of the door here. Well, we unhook it and it's probably adjustable. So there's a lot of good dirt back here. So it's gonna leave a good imprint exactly where it goes. And we're just gonna put on exactly where we take it off. Well, it fits just about perfect. Gonna use a floor jack, but I just had a couple blocks of wood sitting here, so I threw it under the door before I cracked them bolts loose. Boy, they're pretty snug. I would say, like I say, this one's got like a ton of dirt back here. It's gonna leave us a really nice imprint as to exactly where this goes. I'm gonna take one bolt loose here, one bolt completely out first, see if these are adjustable. And they are. That hole's huge. So there's a lot of room for adjustment there. So make sure you either, you know, use a Sharpie or something to scribe around that so you know where this goes. Because I imagine here, as soon as we crack this loose, it's gonna move. That'll make putting it together a whole lot easier. You can just put it back where it was, assuming the door, you know, worked prior to this. It only stand to reason that if we put it back where it was, it would continue to work as well as it did. In this case, better, because it's going to open and close now. Second bolt. We're gonna have to slide the door back a little bit here. Get that whole roller assembly out. So what we're gonna want to do is take that seat clip off. We don't have a new one, so don't send it flying. And make sure we got the right hinge first, I guess. Yeah, we do. It looks like we've got to drive this pin out. It is splined on the bottom edge there. That's what it looks like. It's got little knurls cut into it. Make sure we get this oriented correctly. Go like that. Stick our new one up there. Line it back up. Whack it back through. Might have been able to do it in the vehicle, I don't know. Probably take the chance of damaging something. I think this is a better idea. Do it either way you like. You think you can get it out while it's in the car. Put our C-clip back on. And now it's spring-loaded again. Our cables are going to lock into this. Well, you can see our old one right here. These are our old cables. Like, tip them. Just like that, pretty self-explanatory. So that's what I'm going to be doing, because I may not be able to show that. There's our rollers. There's our old ones. They were still there. Usually I've seen these before where these things are, you know, busted right off. Just riding back and forth on some pegs. Let's get this done. Now let me, I should just bring this door ahead a little. I don't have much room to move it, but you have a lock. Okay. Bring it through the edge of my block anyways. Get that back in. Bring it back to the lock position where I had it initially. I can very easily see on the door where this was. Started back in it. What am I thinking? Big dummy. Probably hook my cables up first, right? Sheesh. Well, I'll leave that there. Let's go fish that front cable. Get ahead of myself. Back out of there. Let me get my front cable hooked up. So it's just like I showed you. I just fished my front cable up through the track and just got kind of sitting here suspended. Take my rear cable, get that up in the hole where it belongs. Then we'll put our roller in. Jeez, that would have stunk. Get that all put together. So there. Now we're where we need to be. Get that cable up in there where it belongs. Got cable hooks up in that little U-shaped piece. A lot of this stuff is quite self-explanatory, but it seems to be very common sense if when you start putting it together. Now we can go ahead and put our bolts back in. Line our door back up. Get a little bit of tension on these cables. It should be done. I got the hinge in exactly where it belongs. We've got our wire cable routed in there correctly. I think we're in good shape. Once you're certain that everything's good outside, you know, don't go cycling your door yet, because the cables are still loose. We gotta tighten them up. Just push the pins in and that's it. The door cables outside should be tight now. Well, this may sound absolutely ridiculous, but I don't recall where we left off. I just had somebody stop and I'd help them out for a while. So at any rate, we had everything hooked up. I think what I want to do is test the motor. I did poke real quick just to see if there was a reset procedure for the module. And it sounds to me, just from the quick glance, I didn't spend much time looking, but that it's pretty much automatic. Basically, it was just like, close the door, open the door, that's it. That's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna kick it on and see if it works. We're just gonna take off on its own. Well, never mind. And evidently that was only if there's a power interruption, so it appears that we have no type of rehoming procedure. Let's go see if the button works. Wonderful. This here's one of those jobs that's taking 20 times longer than it should because it's summertime. I'm working when my door is open. And what that means to Joe Schmo driving by is means that you're open. So they just stop. But anyhow, price of doing business, I guess. What are you gonna do, you know? Let's get the speaker put back in this thing and just get this thing buttoned up. Should go back together pretty quick. Now that we know everything works, the only thing that's nice about somebody bringing their car in when it's like an absolute pigsty, you don't have to worry about getting dirty. You know, if this thing come in and it was all mint, and you know, we'd have to lay down all the interior stuff so we wouldn't get it dirty. I mean, not that I'm getting this thing all covered in grease or anything, but I cleaned all out of crap before we started. So we're gonna get this fish back down, get that loop back around the wire harness down there. Get this re-stuck back on. Start popping the inside back together. It's a little tricky to get it down in, and it goes around, let's see, what is that, just the wiring harness here, it goes around this wiring harness, that little loop I was having a hard time with initially. It's kind of a pisser. I had to fish around with a screwdriver, and then you can reach in and kind of pull that flap around, so perhaps if I was doing it again, I may put this piece on prior to sticking this duck and stuff back in there, because it might allow you to get in there with your fingers a little better, but either way, I was able to get it and get it fish around and stuck back on. Well, I think it's time to throw this big honker back on here. Yep, there's nothing that we forgot. I hate that feeling when you think you forgot something. And you don't want to tear it all back apart for one silly thing. Got our seat belts, let me get this thing, do this the right way, get my seat belt laced back in here. So I'm gonna lace that seat belt in, and then got the other one up here too. Make sure your seat belts are tight and you've already tightened everything up, hopefully. Gonna pull that C-pillar trim back. That I think we slipped it up underneath because for whatever reason we avoided taking it off all the way, which is fine. set back up there loosely. They really self-align quite well, to be honest with you. Assuming you have all the tabs in where they belong. And we'll that snapped in really nice. Put our seat belt back in. Come back here and so you guys see me back here.
Another fun night,
Eric. Oh yeah, you got it. Tabs. I just had to pull this weather stripping back. You can look right in there. There's those two tabs that were right here. You got the one screw there. Push the weather stripping back on. I mean, they're pretty easy, really. We'll get this front weather stripping and that threshold back on. But I think before we do a bunch of crawling in and out, might better just do whatever we got to do while we're sitting right here. Get all of our seat belts. Get them all rearranged. Of course, you can't see what I'm doing, but get that one done. We're going to tighten that up. I'm going to tighten it up down here on the bottom. We'll come down here, get that started. So that way there, when we get out there, we can torque that down. Okay. Perfect. Trim piece back on. They go on a ton easier than they come off. Nice. Reinstall your other seat belt here down on the floor. We'll snap our trim piece back over it. You see there? I don't think that clicked in all the way in the back. Must have missed the groove. I got out of my groove, man. There, got it that time. Got a cargo net nut that's got to go back on there. Okay, I think that's pretty much it for this quarter panel. Shouldn't be any more tools required here, so we'll pick up all our stuff. There really isn't any special tools for this. Basic, just standard sockets, ratchet extension, a couple wrenches, screwdrivers. I used some of the garbage I found in the vehicle to hold the nuts and bolts and things like that. You might want that. An old yogurt container, perhaps. All right. Got those metal tangs there, remember? We gotta get those pushed over so the weather stripping grabs a hold of them. I think I missed that one. I did. There. Get our threshold. We got that sitting right over here. Containers in that. Move the pizza plate. Oops. That lines up pretty good. Don't forget to tighten your seatbelt up here, get that done, and then we'll pull that little rubber cover off, and we're done right here. Just want to take it a little ways and stop. It'll make putting that metal piece in there a little bit easier. Let's see. I think we hit grooves. You got a bolt you gotta put back there. It takes 10 millimeter just like we took it apart. Try to make sure it's pushed back all the way. Now we gotta go put the screw in the front. That you can get right through there with a long screwdriver. Put our tail light back in. Plug it in first. I got just the one peg that lines up in there. The peg that you could like pull a truck out of a ditch with. Them things are always so tough. You know, they click in like nobody's business, but you just gotta have a forklift take them out. Put on our rear threshold, but in order to do that, we gotta put our seat back up. My seat's pretty rough looking. Leave that like that, and then we'll just take and pop the top of our threshold back in. I did put that little piece there for the child anchor. That was just popped out, I was laying down in here. I snapped it back together for him. Let's see if we can't line this one up. Side. Now you push in, then down inside the trunk, you'll see where your two cargo net holes go, holders rather. Put the stud sticking out there, you got a screw mount. Last but not least, you have to reinstall the garbage. Then you're done. Move that front seat back in there. Okay, I think we're back to where we started. Well, there you have it. Another late night at the shop. But you do what you gotta do. So here's the old motor. And you can see that job wasn't too bad. It was actually pretty easy. Just a little bit time consuming. And it makes me wonder, you know, did he jump the gun? And make a, you know, I don't know, I think this is $400 or something. It wasn't cheap, put it that way. I think it's over $300. I don't know. I don't really recall. He needed it. I ordered it. I got it. We put it in. Was it just a pound up roller or was it, what was it? I don't know. He cut the cable in a fury and I think it was, may have been an expensive mistake, but in either case, the motor was probably gonna wear out at some point, or maybe it did, I don't know. Like I say, cut the cable so we don't really know. Yeah, hope you guys liked the video. I don't know what it's gonna turn out like. I got interrupted probably like 6 or 7 times doing that. So, you know, somebody pulling, shut the camera off, you know, do what I had to do. That's why it's dark out. And I'm hearing more doors shut out there. So I'm gonna wrap it up. At any rate, viewers, I hope you liked the video. I hope you learned a little bit something from it. And perhaps if you're doing your own sliding door motor, I hope it goes easy for you. The left side, the driver's side, I assume is much easier because you don't have the heater control unit in a way, you don't have that whole big HVAC box. But realistically, when it comes down to it, that didn't add a whole lot more time because it only added, what, 3, 4, 5 more bolts. We had that little module sitting on the corner, you have to take that out. The 3 bolts holding in the HVAC unit. And if I remember it, what, that one little white clip on the duct and that one little, you know, push retainer up on top on that air duct, and then pick it up, slide out of the way. So it adds, what, 5, 10 minutes, you know. Or whatever, you know, using power tools, it adds a minute and a half. So I don't think that's a big issue, although you kind of got to, you know, you got to work around it a little bit, but really it's not that hard. Yeah, I guess we'll leave it at that. It was pretty simple, pretty straightforward job. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, leave them down in the comment box below, and I'll do my best to get back at you in a timely fashion, or we can start a conversation and we can all help each other out. So thanks for watching. Check us out on Facebook. You can like us there. You can find us on Google Plus too. And if you want to join us socially there. And just remember, viewers, if I can do it, you can do it. Thanks for watching.